In this assignment, we're going to look at taking a project created in Unity 4, in this case, the Nightmares project, which is available as a free download on the Asset Store, and upgrading it to Unity 5. We're going to focus on the audio capability of Unity 5, including using audio mixers and audio effects. To upgrade the project, we're going to focus on three areas. We're going to create two audio mixers and route all of our audio sources to groups in those mixers. We're going to set up some effects processing to shape the mix at runtime, and we're also going to look at how to control our mix at runtime using scripting. We're going to cover this in two videos. In this video, we'll look at signal flow with the audio mixer and using audio effects in your mix. Let's begin by creating some new audio mixer assets, which we'll use to manage the audio signal flow in our project. We'll highlight our audio folder, go to the Create menu, and choose Audio Mixer. We'll call this first mixer Master Mixer, and we're going to make a second mixer called Sound Effects. Next, we'll open our audio mixer window under Window, Audio Mixer. You can also choose Command 8 on Mac or Control 8 on PC. I've docked my audio mixer at the bottom of the screen. Let's give it a little bit more screen real estate as well. We're currently looking at the sound effects mixer. To look at the master mixer, we can click its name in the mixers list below. Master mixer has only one group, the master. We're going to add some groups so that we can route in our sound effects mixer and our music. Let's create some new groups in Master Mixer. We'll highlight the master group, click the plus button, and then highlight it again so that the second group is created as a child of the master. We can click on these names to rename them. Now, our music group is only going to contain a single signal, the output from the audio source on our background music object, which loops our background music. Our sound effects group is going to contain multiple audio signals coming from different game objects, and we may want to control the levels of those independently. This is why we've created the sound effects mixer, and what we want to do now is route the output of the entire sound effects mixer into the sound effects group of Master Mixer. We'll do this by dragging the sound effects mixer onto Master Mixer, and then selecting the group that we want to route that mixer's output into. In this case, sound effects. Now we can see that sound effects has become a child of Master Mixer and will route its output into the sound effects group of Master Mixer. In sound effects, we're going to create some new groups as well. We'll call these player, enemies, and gunshots. Notice that since Gunshots was created with the Enemies group highlighted, it's been made a child of Enemies. We're going to want to make that a child of the Master so that its signal will flow directly into the Master group and then into the Sound Effects group of Master Mixer. With our groups created, it's time to route the outputs of our audio sources to the groups that we've made. Let's start with the player. The player has an audio source on gun barrel end, which is currently routed directly to the audio listener in the scene. We're going to go ahead and choose a new output for that, in this case, the gunshots group of our sound effects mixer. On the parent player game object, we have another audio source which plays the player vocalization sound effects. We're going to go ahead and select the output for that and route that to the player group of our sound effects mixer. After making those changes to the player object, let's make sure that we hit apply to save them to the player prefab. We're also going to configure the output routing for our enemy prefabs. To do this, we're going to go to the completed assets folder, prefabs, and we'll start with our Helifant prefab. We'll scroll down, select the output of the Helifant audio source, and choose the enemies group of our sound effects mixer. We'll do the same for our Zombear and our Zombunny prefabs. The only remaining audio source that we need to assign is our background music. Select the background music game object in the scene, and on the audio source, we'll choose the output and assign it directly to the music group of Master Mixer. With our audio sources now routed into our new audio mixers, we're going to add some effects processing. Let's open the audio mixer, and we're going to select Master Mixer. And on the music group, we're going to choose Add, Low Pass Simple. Low Pass Simple is a low pass filter, which attenuates frequencies above the cutoff frequency, making them quieter. Let's test our scene and hear how the low pass filter sounds. So as we pull the cutoff down, we can hear the high frequencies are attenuated. As you can hear, the music is still a little loud over the sound effects. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to pull the volume down, I think to about negative 10 decibels. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add a little bit of dynamic volume control using the duck volume audio effect. We're going to go ahead and click Add on the music group, select duck volume. And now what we need to do is we need to route some signal from the group that we want to cause our music to duck in volume. We're going to use the sound effects group so that when the sound effects play, the music will automatically get quieter. In order for the duck volume effect to be able to receive signal from the sound effects group, we're going to need to use a send audio effect. On the sound effects group, we're going to click Add and choose Send. The send effect allows us to duplicate our audio signal and route it elsewhere in the audio mixer. In this case, we're going to route it to our duck volume effect by choosing Music Duck Volume from the bus menu of the send. With the bus selected, we're going to turn up the send level all the way. This is how loud the duplicate signal is going to be, which is being routed to the duck volume effect. In this case, this won't add any audible level to our project because we're using the sidechain input of the duck volume only as a control signal. With our send and our duck volume effect set up, let's play the scene and test again. We can see that the volume that's being received is not exceeding the threshold of the duck volume effect. The duck volume effect will not actually begin to lower the volume of the music until the threshold is exceeded. Let's play the scene and experiment with the threshold value. What we want is for the threshold to be low enough that the sound effects will cause the duck volume to begin turning down the music when the sound effects play. Edit in play mode. So we've arrived at this sort of negative 34 value, which sounds pretty good because when our sound effects are playing, we could hear that the music is getting reduced, and the net effect is that our sound effects feel a little bit louder and more present, but we haven't had to sacrifice music volume overall in order to do that. For detailed information about duck volume and send effects, see the information linked below. With our two mixers and our audio effects set up, it's time to prepare them for script control at runtime. The first thing that we're going to do is to create two audio mixer snapshots, which are going to control the state of the mixer and allow us to recall different mixer states, including levels and effect settings. We're going to start by creating a new audio mixer snapshot by clicking the plus button in the snapshots area. We'll call that one paused. And we'll name our first snapshot Unpaused. Both of these snapshots will be saved to Master Mixer because that's where they were created. In the Unpaused snapshot, we'll keep our mixer settings the same. In the Paused snapshot, we're going to change the value of the low pass simple effect and pull the filter cutoff down, let's say, to 365 Hz. We can test quickly how that sounds. edit in play mode, and recall the pause snapshot by clicking on it. Now that we've got our project set up, we're going to end part one. In part two, we'll look at controlling the mix via scripting.